Now let's talk about surface tension. Now with surface tension, we bring into picture two very important terms, and that are cohesion and adhesion. Now what are these things? Well, these two things are both forms of molecular attraction. So both of them, they tell us something about the forms of molecular attraction. Okay. Now if you talk about cohesion, well, cohesion, it enables a liquid to resist the tensile stress. So let me define it. So it enables liquid to resist tensile stress. Whereas if you talk about adhesion, adhesion enables a liquid to adhere to another body. So I would say that body could be of some other material. Okay, so another body. So let us say you have some water, and that water adheres to glass, so that another body becomes glass. Okay, and liquid becomes water. So in a way, I can say that cohesion is the molecular attraction between two molecules or more than two molecules of the same material. Whereas adhesion, it talks about the molecular attraction in between a liquid and some other material. Okay, so this is for different substances and this is for the same substance. Okay, so with the help of this, let's define what is surface tension. Okay, so if I draw, you can say liquid vapor interface. So this is a liquid vapor interface. So this liquid, which is bottom, okay, this is liquid and this is vapor. So liquid and vapor, they are immiscible, so that is why they have an interface. All right, so if you consider a liquid molecule over here, okay, so this will exert equal pressure force in all directions. Okay, so you can say that on this particular point, the pressure from all sides would be same. That's what is the Pascal's law. We'll talk about it in a later video. But if you talk about the molecules at the surface, okay, so this has zero resultant. This has zero resultant. But if you talk about the molecules at the interface, they will have some net resultant. So this has a vertically downward force. All right. So then you'll have these two horizontal forces. So these two horizontal forces on both the molecules, they are cancelled. Okay. But if you talk about this vertical force, it is not balanced. You'll have a net resultant in these directions. Due to these net resultants, you'll see that this entire interface or this entire surface is behaving as if it is a film which is being stretched from the two ends. Okay, so this is what we call surface tension. So this is not this much. I'm just giving you a very zoomed in picture. Over a very long span of this interface, you'll see a very little curvature, but it will be like it is being stretched from both the ends. Okay, so this will be something like this. Now we measure the surface tension as the force per unit length. So it will be sigma, which is the symbol for the surface tension. The unit would be Newton per meter. Now with the help of this surface tension, which makes the interface appear like a stretched membrane. Okay, so this is what is surface tension. So one of the very important effects of surface tension is capillarity. So what is capillarity? Well, this capillarity is a phenomena that is predominant in very fine tubes. In very, very fine tubes, or I would say, you know, tubes of very, very small diameters. Okay, so if you talk about, let us say, this is, you know, container in which some fluid is there or some liquid is there, and then you have a very fine tube like this, all right, and when the atmospheric pressure is acting on the surface of this liquid, it will try and rise. So this this interface would be somewhere over here. So this rise, and there might be a fall also, or fall of this liquid inside this very fine tube is called the capillarity effect. Now, when will this liquid rise or when will this liquid fall? Now, first of all, the interface is not a straight one, it's a curved one. So if you are having a capillarity rise, so if this is the tube, then in rise you will have this kind of a surface. This is called a meniscus. This is called a meniscus. And this meniscus is majorly due to surface tension. Okay. So you have, this is the free surface of the liquid, and this distance is the capillarity rise. So this is the capillarity rise. If you talk about the capillarity depression, then it will be the other way around. So this is the tube that you have. Okay. This is the free surface of the liquid. And the liquid is now like this. So the meniscus is the opposite of what you have in the capillarity rise. Okay, so this is how your liquid will look like. And this distance is called the capillarity depression. So in this, your liquid is rising, and in this, the liquid is falling or depressing. Okay, now see, when will your liquid rise and when will your liquid fall? So if the cohesion is less as compared to adhesion, then your liquid will rise, and if the cohesion is predominating, then it will fall. So this is when the force of cohesion or cohesive effects, okay, is less, and this is when cohesion is more as compared to adhesive effects. Okay, so this is what we understand by capillarity. Now we need to have a mathematical formula to calculate the capillarity rise or capillarity depression. Okay, for that let's draw a basic diagram. So we'll draw a very basic diagram. Let us say we will calculate for capillarity rise, and the same formula can be used to find out the capillarity depression. So let us say this is the rise. Alright, and this is the rise that is there, H, and this meniscus is having a stretch like this. So this stretch is pulling the water upwards due to surface tension, sigma, okay, and the weight of the liquid is acting vertically downwards. So to be in equilibrium, the surface tension has to be equal to the weight of the liquid column. So let us say this angle is theta. So you will get a cos component of sigma. You will have sigma cos theta. So this sigma cos theta, or the force due to sigma cos theta, has to be equal to the weight of the liquid column for equilibrium. So this is force per unit length. So what is the length of the meniscus? 2 pi r. Let us say the radius of the tube is r. So it will be equal to 2 pi r into sigma into cos theta. That is the total upward force, length into force per unit length, is equal to the weight. Now what is weight? Weight is mass into gravity. So this is the force per unit length, and you multiply that with the length, you get the total force, which is vertically upward. So now let's find out the total weight. So weight is mass into gravity. What is mass? Mass is density into volume, okay, into gravity. What is density into gravity? It's the specific weight. So that becomes omega into volume. Now what is the omega for a cylindrical body? For this much height, or for this much cylindrical shape, the volume is pi into r square into h, and then you have the specific weight. Okay, so I'll write that, write this down as pi into r square into h into omega. So now I can strike off pi r r. So the value of h, it comes out to be 2 sigma cos theta upon r into omega. That is the mathematical value to find out the capillarity rise or the capillarity depression or capillarity fall. Okay, so I'll just reiterate the terms. H is the fall or rise or fall. Sigma is the surface tension. Theta is the angle of contact. Okay, so if I talk about water, if the tube is entirely clean, then theta is equal to 0 degree. When you have water in glass, and theta is equal to 140 for mercury in glass. So this kind of rise is basically for water, and this kind of fall is very, very evident in mercury. Okay, so r is the radius of the capillary tube and omega is the specific weight. Okay, so I hope you understood this mathematical derivation and this explanation of the topic of surface tension. Now let's move on to the next video and talk about another property of fluid, that is vapor pressure.